This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. A shaped charge is an explosive charge shape to focus the effect of the explosive's energy. Various types are used to cut and form metal, initiate nuclear weapons, penetrate armor, and complete wells in the oil and gas industry. A typical modern shaped charge, with a metal liner on the charge cavity, can penetrate armor steel to a depth of 7 or more times the diameter of the charge. Charge diameters, CD, though greater depths of 10. 4 defenses, 5 variants, 51 linear shaped charges, 52 explosively formed penetrator, 53 tandem warhead, 54 Voitenko compressor, 55 nuclear shaped charges. 6 examples in the media, 7 see also, 8 references, 9 further reading, 10 external links. Munro effect. The Munro or Newman effect is the focusing of blast energy by a hollow or void cut on a surface of an explosive. The earliest mention of hollow charges occurred in 1792. Franz Xaver von Baader, 1765-1841, was a German mining engineer at that time. In a mining journal, he advocated a conical space at the forward end of a blasting charge to increase the explosive's effect and thereby save powder. The idea was adopted, for a time, in Norway and in the mines of the Harz Mountains of Germany, although the only available explosive at the time was gunpowder, which is not a high explosive and hence incapable of producing the shock wave that the shaped charge effect requires. The first true hollow charge effect was achieved in 1883, by Max von Forster, 1845-1905, chief of the nitrocellulose factory of Wolf. Charge of dynamite 9.5 pounds in weight and untamped was detonated on it, a hole 3 inches in diameter was blown clear through the wall. Anti-tank round that was based on the hollow charge effect. When the Austrian government showed no interest in pursuing the idea, Tomanek moved to Berlin's Technische Hochschule, where he continued his studies under the ballistics expert Carl Julius Kranz. There in 1935, he and Helmuth von Huttern developed a prototype anti-tank round. Although the weapon's performance proved disappointing, Tomanek continued his developmental work, collaborating with Hubert Chardon at the Waffeninstitut der Luftwaffe Air Force Weapons Institute in Braunschweig. By 1937, Chardin believed that hollow charge effects were due to the interactions of shock waves. It was during the testing of this idea that, on February 4, 1938, Tomanek conceived the shaped charge explosive or Holodungs-Auskleidungseffekt, hollow charge liner effect. It was Gustav Adolf Thomer who in 1938 first visualized, by flash radiography, the metallic jet produced by a shaped charge explosion. Meanwhile, Henry Hans Mohaupt, a chemical engineer in Switzerland, had independently developed a shaped charge munition in 1935, which was demonstrated to the Swiss, French, British, and U.S. militaries during World War II. Shaped charge munitions were developed by Germany Panzerschreck, Panzerfaust, Panzerwerfmine, Mistel, Britain PIAT, Beehive Charge, the Soviet Union RPG-43, RPG-6, and the U.S. Bazooka. The development of shaped charges revolutionized anti-tank warfare. Tanks faced a serious vulnerability from a weapon that could be carried by an infantry or aircraft. One of the earliest uses of shaped charges was by German glider-borne troops against the Belgian Fort Eben Mil. These demolition charges, developed by Dr. Wolfgen of the German Ordnance Office, were unlined explosive charges and didn't produce a metal jet like the modern heat warheads due to the lack of metal liner. They shook the turrets but they did not destroy them, and other airborne troops were forced to climb on the turrets and smash the gun barrels. Applications modern military. Further information, high explosive anti-tank warhead. The common term in military terminology for shaped charge warheads is high explosive anti-tank heat. Heat warheads are frequently used in anti-tank guided missiles, unguided rockets, gun-fired projectiles both spun and unspun, rifle grenades, landmines, bomblets, torpedoes, and various other weapons. Non-military. In non-military applications, shaped charges are used in explosive demolition of buildings and structures, in particular for cutting through metal piles, columns and beams, and for boring holes in steelmaking. Small shaped charges are often used to pierce taps that have become plugged with slag. They are also used in quarrying, breaking up ice, breaking log jams, felling trees, and drilling post holes. Shaped charges are used most extensively in the petroleum and natural gas industries, in particular in the completion of oil and gas wells, in which they are detonated to perforate the metal casing of the well at intervals to admit the influx of oil and gas. Function A40. varies along its length, decreasing from the front. This variation in jet velocity stretches it and eventually leads to its breakup into particles over time. The particles tend to fall out of alignment, which reduces the depth of penetration at long standoffs. Also, at the apex of the cone, which forms the very front of the jet, the liner does not have time to be fully accelerated before it forms its part of the jet. This results in its small part of jet being projected at a lower velocity than jet formed later behind it. As a result, the initial parts of the jet coalesce to form a pronounced wider tip portion. Most of the jet travels at hypersonic speed. The tip moves at 7 to 14. With a standard deviation of 40 degrees Celsius, a tin lead liner with comp B fill average is 569 degrees Celsius. With a standard deviation of 34 degrees Celsius, the tin lead liner also had a slower jet tip velocity of 63. Angles can result in jet bifurcation, or even in the failure of the jet to form at all. This is attributed to the collapse velocity being above a certain threshold, normally slightly higher than the liner material's bulk sound speed. Other widely used shapes include hemispheres, tulips, trumpets, ellipses, and biconics. The various shapes yield jets with different velocity and mass distributions. Liners have been made from many materials, including various metals and glass. The deepest penetrations are achieved with a dense, ductile metal, and a very common choice has been copper for some modern anti-armor weapons, molybdenum and pseudo-alloys of tungsten filler and copper binder 9:1, thus density is approximately equals 18. Greatest ductility, which delays the breakup of the jet into particles as it stretches in charges for oil well completion. However, it is essential that a solid slug or carrot not be formed, since it would plug the hole just penetrated and interfere with the influx of oil in the petroleum industry. Therefore, liners are generally fabricated by powder metallurgy, often of pseudo-alloys which, if unsintered, yield jets that are composed mainly of dispersed fine metal particles. Unsintered cold-pressed liners, however, are not waterproof and tend to be brittle, which makes them easy to damage during handling. Bimetallic liners, usually zinc-lined copper, can be used. During jet formation, the zinc layer vaporizes and a slug is not formed. The disadvantage is an increased cost and dependency of jet formation on the quality of bonding. The two layers' low melting point below 500. Phase can be achieved also with castable alloys, e.g., copper with a low melting point metal insoluble in copper, such as bismuth, 1-5% lithium, or up to 50%, usually 15-30% lead. The size of inclusions can be adjusted by thermal treatment. Non-homogeneous distribution of the inclusions can also be achieved. Other additives can modify the alloy properties: tin 4-8%, nickel up to 30%, and often together with tin, up to 8% aluminium, phosphorus forming brittle phosphides, or 1-5% silicon form brittle inclusions serving as crack initiation sites. Up to 30% zinc can be added to lower the material cost and to form additional brittle phases. Oxide glass liners produce jets of low density, therefore yielding less penetration depth. Double layer liners, with one layer of a less dense but pyrophoric metal, e.g. aluminum or magnesium, can be used to enhance incendiary effects following the armor piercing action. Explosive welding can be used for making those, as then the metal-metal interface is homogeneous, does not contain significant amount of intermetallics, and does not have adverse effects to the formation of the jet. The penetration depth is proportional to the maximum length of the jet, which is a product of the jet tip velocity and time to particulation. The jet tip velocity depends on bulk sound velocity in the liner material. The time to particulation is dependent on the ductility of the material. The maximum achievable jet velocity is roughly 234 times the sound velocity in the material. The speed can reach 10. The cone tip is subjected to acceleration of about 25 million grams. The jet tail reaches about 2-5. Warheads, but, at present, due to its sensitivity, this has been in the form of the PBX composite LX19 CL20 and Estane binder. Other features: a waveshaper is a body, typically a disc or cylindrical block of an inert material, typically solid or foamed plastic, but sometimes metal, perhaps hollow, inserted within the explosive for the purpose of changing the path of the detonation wave. The effect is to modify the collapse of the cone and resulting jet formation, with the intent of increasing penetration performance. Wave waveshapers are often used to save space. A shorter charge with a waveshaper can achieve the same performance as a longer charge without a waveshaper. Another useful design feature is sub-calibration, the use of a liner having a smaller diameter caliber than the explosive charge in an ordinary charge. The explosive near the base of the cone is so thin that it is unable to accelerate the adjacent liner to sufficient velocity to form an effective jet in a sub-calibrated charge. This part of the device is effectively cut off, resulting in a shorter charge with the same performance. Defenses during World War II, the precision of the charge's construction and its detonation mode were both inferior to modern warheads. This lower precision caused the jet to curve and to break up at an earlier time, and hence at a shorter distance the resulting dispersion decreased the penetration depth for a given cone diameter and also shortened the optimum standoff distance, since the charges were less effective at larger standoffs. Side and turret skirts known as Scherzen fitted to some German tanks to protect against ordinary anti-tank rifles were fortuitously found to give the jet room to disperse and hence reduce also heat penetration. The use of add-on spaced armor skirts on armored vehicles may have the opposite effect and actually increase the penetration of some shaped charge warheads due to constraints in the length of the projectile missile. The built-in standoff on many warheads is less than the optimum distance in such cases. The skirting effectively increases the distance between the armor and the target, and the warhead detonates closer to its optimum standoff. Skirting should not be confused with cage armor, which is used to damage the fusing system of RPG-7 projectiles. The armor works by deforming the inner and outer ogives and shorting the firing circuit between the rocket's piezoelectric nose probe and rear fuse assembly. Cage armor can also cause the projectile to pitch up or down on impact, lengthening the penetration path for the shaped charge's penetration stream. If the nose probe strikes one of the cage armor slats, the warhead will function as normal. Variants: there are several different forms of shaped charge. Linear shaped charges. Linear shaped charge. A linear shaped charge LSC has a lining with V-shaped profile and varying length. The lining is surrounded with explosive, the explosive then encased within a suitable material that serves to protect the explosive and to confine tamp it on detonation. At detonation, the focusing of the explosive high pressure wave as it becomes incident to the side wall causes the metal liner of the LSC to collapse, creating the cutting force. The detonation projects into the lining, to form a continuous, knife-like planar jet. The jet cuts any material in its path, to a depth depending on the size and materials used in the charge for the cutting of complex geometries. There are also flexible versions of the linear-shaped charge, these with a lead or high-density foam sheathing and a ductile, flexible lining material, which also is often lead. LSCs are commonly used in the cutting of rolled steel joists, RSJ, and other structural targets, such as in the controlled demolition of buildings. LSCs are also used to separate the stages of multistage rockets. Explosively formed penetrator main article. Explosively formed penetrator formation of an EFP warhead. USAF Research Laboratory. The explosively formed penetrator EFP is also known as the self-forging fragment SFF. Explosively formed projectile EFP, self-forging projectile SEFOP, plate charge, and Mizne-Chardin MS charge. An EFP uses the action of the explosive's detonation wave and to a lesser extent the propulsive effect of its detonation products to project and deform a plate or dish of ductile metal such as copper, iron, or tantalum into a compact high-velocity projectile, commonly called the slug. This slug is projected toward the target at about 2 km per second. The chief advantage of the EFP over a conventional EG, conical-shaped charge is its effectiveness at very great standoffs, equal to hundreds of times the charge's diameter, perhaps 100 meters for a practical device. The EFP is relatively unaffected by first-generation reactive armor and can travel up to perhaps 1,000 charge diameters CDs before its velocity becomes ineffective at penetrating armor due to aerodynamic drag, or successfully hitting the target becomes a problem. The impact of a ball or slug EFP normally causes a large diameter but relatively shallow hole, of, at most, a couple of CDs if the EFP perforates the armor. Spalling and extensive behind armor effects. Bay, also called behind armor damage, bad will occur. The bay is mainly caused by the high temperature and high velocity armor and slug fragments being injected into the interior space and the blast overpressure caused by this debris. More modern EFP warhead versions, through the use of advanced initiation modes, can also produce long rods, stretched slugs, multi-slugs and finned rod slug projectiles. The long rods are able to penetrate a much greater Depth of armor, at some loss to bay, multi-slugs are better at defeating light or area targets and the finned projectiles are much more accurate. The use of this warhead type is mainly restricted to lightly armored areas of main battle tanks MBT such as the top, belly and rear armored areas. It is well suited for the attack of other less heavily protected armored fighting vehicles AFV and in the breaching of material targets buildings, bunkers, bridge supports, etc. The newer rod projectiles may be effective against the more heavily armored areas of MBT's weapons using the EFP principle have already been used in combat. The smart submunitions in the CBU-97 cluster bomb used by the U.S. Air Force and Navy in the 2003 Iraq War employed this principle, and the U.S. Army is reportedly experimenting with precision-guided artillery shells under Project SADARM Seek and Destroy Armor. There are also various other projectile bonus, 642 German marks and rocket submunitions Motiv 3M, 642 German marks and mines MIF, TMRP-6 that use EFP principle. Examples of EFP warheads are U.S. patents 5,038,683 and U.S. 6,606,951 tandem warheads. Some modern anti-tank rockets RPG-27, RPG-29 and missiles TOW-2B, ERYX, HOT, Milan use a tandem warhead-shaped charge, consisting of two separate shaped charges, one in front of the other, typically with some distance between them. TOW-2A was the first to use tandem warheads in the mid-1980s, an aspect of the weapon which the U.S. Army had to reveal under news media and congressional pressure resulting from the concern that NATO anti-tank missiles were ineffective against Soviet tanks that were fitted with the new era boxes. The Army revealed that a 40. When the shaped charge detonates, most of its energy is focused on the steel plate, driving it forward and pushing the test gas ahead of it. Ames translated this idea into a self-destroying shock tube. A 66-pound shaped charge accelerated the gas in a 3 cm glass-walled tube 2 meters in length. The velocity of the resulting shock wave was 220,000 feet per second 67. Produced in fact. For example, the early nuclear weapons designer Ted Taylor was quoted as saying, in the context of shaped charges, a 1 kiloton fission device, shaped properly, could make a hole 10 feet in diameter 1,000 feet into solid rock. Also, a nuclear-driven explosively formed penetrator was apparently proposed for terminal ballistic missile defense in the 1960s. Examples in the media. The Krakatoa-shaped charge system by Alford Technologies Limited. The future weapons program of the Discovery Channel featured the Krakatoa, a simple shaped charge weapon system designed by Alford Technologies for special operations deployment. The weapon consisted of a simple plastic outer shell, a copper cone and a volume of plastic explosive. This device was effective at penetrating 1-inch thick 25 targets. PDF Science. Carrot C. Charles E. Munro 1888 on certain phenomena produced by the detonation of gun cotton. Proceedings of the Newport Natural Historical Society 1883-1886. Report No. 6. Charles E. Munro 1888 Wave-like effects produced by the detonation of gun cotton. American Journal of Science, Volume 36, pp. 48-50. Charles E. Munro 1888 Modern Explosives, Scribner's Magazine, Volume 3, pp. 563-576. Kennedy 1990, pp. 5-6. Carrot C. E. Munro 1894 Executive Document No. 20, 53rd Congress, First Session, Washington, D.C. Carrot Charles E. Munro 1900 The Applications of Explosives, Appleton's Popular Science Monthly, Volume 56, pp. 300-312, 444-455. A description of Munro's first shaped charge experiment appears on p. 453. Carat Munro 1900, p. 453. Carat Kennedy 1990, p. 6. Carat It makes steel flow like mud. Popular Science, February 1945, pp. 65-69. Carat G. I. Brown 1998. The Big Bang, A History of Explosives. Stroud. Gloucestershire, Sutton Publishing Limited. P. German Wikipedia, Karl Kranz. Carat Helmut W. Malnig 2006. Professor Tominik und die Entwicklung der Präzisionsholodung. Professor Tominik and the Development of the Precision Hollow Charge. Truppendienst, No. 289. Available online at Bundeswehr Federal Army of Austria. Carat Kennedy 1990, p. 9. Carat C. Kennedy 1990, p. 63. Krell 2009, p. 513. Carat C. H. Mohaupt, Chapter 11, Shaped Charges and Warheads, in F. B. Pollard and J. A. Arnold, eds., Aerospace Ordnance Handbook, Englewood Cliffs, New Jersey, Prentice Hall, 1966. Kennedy, 1990, pp. 10-11. William P. Walters, September 1990, The Shaped Charge Concept, Part 2, The History of Shaped Charges, Technical Report B. R. L. T. R. 3158, U.S. Army Laboratory Command, Ballistic Research Laboratory, Aberdeen Proving Ground, Maryland, P. 7. Available online at Defense Technical Information Center. Carrot, Donald R. Kennedy, History of the Shaped Charge Effect, The First 100 Years, Dr. Kennedy and Associates, Inc., Mountain View, California, 1983. Carrot, John Pike, Shaped Charge, Global Security Org. Carrot, Walters, William, 1998, Fundamentals of Shaped Charges, Softcover Edition with Corrections, ed., Baltimore, Maryland, CMC Press, p. Carrot, Wiley, VCH Verlag GmbH, D69451, Weinheim, 1999, Propellants, Explosives, Pyrotechnics, 24 Effectiveness Factors for Explosive Reactive Armor Systems, page 71. Carrot, Accurate Energetic Systems LLC, Linear Shape Charge. Carrot, Ernest L. Baker, Pai Lin Liu, Brian Fuchs and Barry Fishburne, 1991, High Explosive Assembly for Projecting High Velocity Long Rods. Carrot, Arnold Skline, 2003, Bounding Anti-Tank, Anti-Vehicle Weapon. Carrot, Goodman, A. Army Anti-Tank Candidates Proliferate, Armed Forces Journal International, December 1987, p. 23. Carrot, Jason C. Gilliam and Darren Elkilsmeyer, 2008, Multipurpose Single Initiated Tandem Warhead. Carrot, Klaus Lindstadt and Manfred Clare, 1996, Tandem Warhead with a Secondary Projectile. Carrot, Voitenko Voitenko, A. 1964, Polusini Gazavai Strudge Bolsoj Skorosti, Obtaining High-Speed Gas Jets, Doklady Akademie Nauk, Cesar Reports of the Academy of Sciences of the USSR, 158. Carrot, Global Security, Shaped Charge History. Carrot, Explosive Accelerators, Voitenko Implosion Gun. Carrot, 2, Glass and J.C. Poinso, Implosion Driven Shock Tube. Carrot, Shuzo Fujiwara, 1992, Explosive Technique for Generation of High Dynamic Pressure. Carrot, Z.Y. Liu, Overdriven Detonation of Explosives Due to High-Speed Plate Impact. Carrot, Zhang, Fan Medicine Hat, Alberta. Murray, Stephen Burke, Medicine Hat, Alberta. Higgins, Andrew, Montreal, Quebec, 2005, Super Compressed Detonation Method and Device to Effect Such Detonation. Carrot, Jerry Pentel and Gary G. Fairbanks, 1992, Multiple Stage Munition. Carrot, John M. Heberlin, 2006, Enhancement of Solid Explosive Munitions Using Reflective Casings. Carrot, Frederick J. Mayer, 1988, Materials Processing Using Chemically Driven Spherically Symmetric Implosions. Carrot, Donald R. Garrett, 1972, Diamond Implosion Apparatus. Carrot, L. V. Alfschuler, K. K. Krupnikov, V. N. Panov and R. F. Trunin, 1996, Explosive Laboratory Devices for Shockwave Compression Studies. Carrot, A. A. Giardini and J. E. Tidings, 1962, Diamond Synthesis, Observations on the Mechanism of Formation. Carrot, Lawrence Livermore, National Laboratory, 2004, Going to Extremes. Carrot, Raymond Gene Laws, Peter M. Selliers, Gilbert W. Collins, John H. Eggert, Kanani K. M. Lee, R. Stuart McWilliams, Stephanie Brigu and Paul Lobert, 2007, Achieving High-Density States Through Shockwave Loading of Precompressed Samples. Carrot, F. Winterberg, Conjectured Metastable Super Explosives Formed Under High Pressure for Thermonuclear Ignition. Carrot, Young, K. Bay, 2008, Metastable Inner Shell Molecular State MIMS. Carrot, Andre G. S. Poner, 2008, Fourth Generation Nuclear Weapons, Military Effectiveness and Collateral Effects. Carrot, Dyson, George, Project Orion, The Atomic Spaceship, 1957-1965, P113, ISBN 0-14-027732 3. Carrot, Dyson, Project Orion, P220. Carrot, McPhee, John, The Curve of Binding Energy, P159, ISBN 0-374-51598-0. Carrot, Explosively Produced Flechettes, Jason Report, 66-121, Institute for Defense Analysis, 1966. Carrot, Interview with Dr. Richard Blankenbeckler, http://wowwyporg/history/oholist/5196html. Carrot, YouTube. Elements of Fission Weapon Design. Shaped Bombs Magnify Iraq Attacks. Shaped Charges Pierce the Toughest Targets. The development of the first hollow charges by the Germans in World War II. Use of shaped charges and protection against them in World War II.